Hello again, tourist. Welcome back to Norrath. I am your short hostess with the mostest, your favoriteest gnome mage in all of Norrath and Lucilin and beyond, Shazamopolis. And we are off. In a non-serious note, almost thought I was going to have to give up on this because there was a 2 or 3 day stretch where I was not able to log on because of problems with Daybreak. I was almost ready and willing to go ahead and buy a subscription. And that. You tried to attack me, homie? You tried to attack me? My feelings are hurt. Did you see that? You tried to attack me. Alright, whatever. Oh, shit. I did a bunch of conjuration. He's got the fang. I gave him the shield. I'm not using the shield because I have Fippy's Paw, which gives me intelligence and wisdom and a cold resistance. I'm wondering if the shield is better, though. Oh, I'm not too worried about it. The brass choker, Jolum's tarnished bubble, and the Tavi's linning metal. So, yeah. That's one of the advantages of being a mage. I'm using the advantages for what I can. Now, I debated on what to do. Because at level 15, we could go back into Black Burrow. I believe I've said this before. Black Burrow, you can really milk that zone until you're 20. It gets rough. It gets slow. The mobs start to get very light blue and green. And I decided against that. Blues. I was hoping I could, that they weren't all. I was hoping they were low enough to where I could separate them and kill them on a. Well, I can separate this one. Watch this. Go get him, puppy. Go get him, puppy. Go get him, puppy. And that's a new spell right there we're trying out. Bam! Big hit, big hit. 127, that's a big hit. Burned out light stone. Useless. Hey, hi. I would like. I would like to be able to show you an example of the greater lightstone. Plus, I got a lightstone right there, so I'd like to have a greater lightstone myself. Crude Defiant Cloth, I think I got one of those. And another lightstone. Wisp Essence. Can't remember what they were good for, but they weren't worth much, so I'm not too worried about that. I'm feeling kind of cocky, so we're just going to keep on killing some of these bastards until we get what we want. Ooh, right there. Oh, that's nothing. There we go. Go kill. Kill, kill, kill. Damn, look at that. Only 50% damage in one hit. But yes, I've been trying to decide what to do. Exactly where to go. There it is, a greater lightstone. I need to turn around and put an applause track in there. There's my greater lightstone. You're not going to be able to tell the difference. Well, that sucks. I'll still keep it. Anyways, I was trying to decide where we should go. Crude Defiant. That's what we gotta recruit to find. And there was a number of places I was considering. Like I said, we could have milked Blackboro until 20, but it would have really gotten relatively annoying. We could chase the, if we are going to chase these wolves while we're passing through. Is this the road? Yes, it is. Disadvantage of being short. We are going to look for the wolves while we're passing through. If we do well enough, we may hang out here for a while. If we get a couple of wolves, how many do we need still? We got 4 of 10, so we still need 6. So if we find 3 on the way across, I'll hang out. Go kill him, puppy. Rabbit grizzly. I need to make an assist button. I don't have to make an assist button. Now where in the hell is my road at? Oh, I passed the road. Yeah, I passed the road south. There it is. But yeah, I played around with where to go. We're going to go ahead and look around in Western Karana as we're running east, because Highhold Pass, I believe. Yes, Highhold Pass is. We may be a little bit low, and if we are a little bit low. Okay. We may be a little bit low for Highhold Pass, and if we are, we can always just. Sorry, I got something in my eye. If we're a little bit low, we can always just go ahead and back off and do Eastern Karana or Northern Karana, which is always safe and fun to play the bridge. The bridge is the area between the two zones. So you go ahead and pull your mobs, and if you pull out something you can't handle, you just run across the bridge, go to the other side, and then you start to sink. Oh, okay. I thought I picked up a mob. You just go ahead and run to the other zone and you try the same thing. You do the same thing again until you get to work out for you. Okay. I was afraid for a second. I was like, wait a minute. I thought I was already in Western Karana. I was like, wait a minute. Did this game just freeze? So yeah, we're going to go ahead and go mess with Highhold. Or one of the Karanas. Either way, it'll be fun, it'll be interesting, and I am trying to stick old school for now. So it'll stay with the theme of what I'm trying to do, and that is stay old school. Although I do fully intend to move beyond the old world down here and go on up to Lucelin and do other things. But for now, as I have shown, because I did go to the Plane of Knowledge, and if I was really being old school, I would not have gone to the Plane of Knowledge, at least not willingly. Right now, I'm just going to go to a merchant over here and just show you what it was worth. That way you'll know how poor we all were back in the day. We were poor. Minya Cold Toes. Okay. Don't you love these names? Claw Cap. Small Sewing Kit. Wait a minute, that's not that right there. Three platinum. That's what we used to go crazy for. We used to go crazy for three platinum pieces. That's poor right there. Right, let's go find our mist wolves. Okay. Yeah, people would be so desperate for experience, they'd just start killing anything and they wouldn't worry about faction. They just wanted to level. I should probably also worry about the spiders along the way, because I do need their silk. That way I can work on my tailor skill and make myself some clothes. I'm still practically naked. There's a lot of things I could make by with silk to at least cover me up, so I wouldn't be a naked gnome running around. Keep the little gnome warm, little gnome nu keep the little gnome nubbits from shriveling up. I'm screwing that up. Oh. We got to do what we can. Enter Janis Joplin soundbite. Get it any way you can, little gnome. Get it any way you can. They're not quite 50 years old, so I can't use that. It's still owned by somebody. I was going to go back to the background music. As if I can get the volume right. And just pick a fight. No, a Zuner. See that? Somebody's been out here. That's a corpse. Percent. Mercenary upkeep. Oh. Two percent. I'm guessing that means how long until his corpse degrades? What the hell? Uh-oh, I got a bad feeling about that. Nope, he's not interested in me. I want to say that restless, that wandering spirit has something to do with Shaman Epic, but I could be wrong. It's been a long time since I've done all this. I estimate 10 years. Last time I played this game, I was going to University of Georgia in Athens. That was a long time ago, y'all. Had to throw y'all in there since we're talking about Georgia. Now, if I was only drinking some sweet tea, I'd be happy. And having them eating a peach, too. A peach. Georgia people. Oh, look at that. A wolf. A wolf. Come here, wolf, wolf. I am so happy we found a wolf. Go kill. I'll let the spider get away. Come on now. Oh, jeez. Wolf just flat out running. Animal pelt, tattered animal pelt, chunk of meat. Wow, these wolves drop horrible stuff. I don't even think he's. I think think he's great. He is great. I hit him one time too hard. Oh, I like the nukes. I'm glad I upgraded my nukes. Uh-oh, what's that? I did upgrade all my spells. Cool. Negative. Cool. Bobotomy. Midibits. What the hell? Midibits. I thought I had a good gnome name. But last name Bidelitz. I'm not going there. I'm done with that name. So technically we're halfway through our Mist Wolf thing. If we find two more before we get to the northern plains of Karana, I'll go ahead and double back and do some more hunting. Just because I'm curious as to what it is next. Oh, I already know what it'll be next. The next one will say you're done, go report back to so-and-so or something like that. I'm still disappointed it wasn't more money. But that's part of the downside of playing old school. It's not that much money to be made out here. I'm pretty sure I could go up. In fact, I'm trying to remember the name of the caverns. There were some caverns. Is it the Palladial Caverns? There were some caverns on the moon, which I think we could go to and we would do really well at. Experience points decent. Couple villages. Nice progression as you're working your way through those caverns. I think the loot is okay. Or we could even go up to where the dragonkin come from. Crescent City and all that. Crescent. I don't know if it's called Crescent City or what. Whatever. And we could turn around work outside of that city, the Blightmore, whatever the hell. And the banditos are gray now too. Aww. This is so much like back in the day too. I spent too much time in Blackboro, then I come out here to Western Karana, and there's no experience. Because I should have came out here earlier. But this is just so much damn running, it's not even worth the trouble. Hey, a spider? A giant spider? Plains lion. I need this, like I said, I need the silk. Oh, you just go kill him. I know I'm not chasing them down like I was the other one, but like I said before, I believe you do not get experience if they're gray. Spider legs. That's not. Man. That is not silk. And we're gonna come over here and we're gonna kick his ass just because he's blue, and that means there's like real experience with him. And he's like, come here, kitty, 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 kitty. Come here, kitty, 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 kitty. Now we gonna kick your ass, kitty. Yeah. Uh-huh. Go ahead. Uh-uh. quality kitty. Ruined lion skin. Cannot perform that function right now. Lag. Wait a minute, that guy is 2%. Maybe it was a monk? Oh, I doubt that. He was a corpse. Yeah, we had to show his name if he was alive. Alright, let's go over here and sell. So far, I'm really not seeing any more wolves, so I'm not too worried about being tempted to stay so far. Because it's not playing out too well for me. I think they got patterns too, this one. You see that? There's a spider. Go kill him, puppy. There he is. Or was it a different one I was looking at? It was a different one I was looking at. There we go. Only one silk. What a ripoff. Come on now. Alright, there was another spider up here. Where'd he go? And he's gone. Giant fire beetle. Brown bear. Okay, I'm done. I'm just want to sell some stuff before we... Somebody's been here. Okay. Yes, we'll sell that. We'll sell that too. And that. Hey, stop it. And that. Yes, we don't have a rogue. And don't let me die, people. I will be right back. Someone's at the door. Sorry about that, my neighbor. Okay. Oh, wrong wolf. I'll go kill him anyways. I don't think. Where'd he go? I don't think it's going to be the same wolf. I think that's a completely different wolf. Got a wolf ball? Let's just make sure here. Yeah, completely different wolf. I think I found that out last turn. Yes, and I don't try to edit out interruptions like that. I try to take things out of this like I do other games. My logic is simple. And this game is a grind. There is no real end game involved. Hey, another spider. Let's see what. You're not blue, so we'll just grab the spider. Go kill him, puppy. There's no real end game. I mean, you can become a raid, you can start raiding, but they always try to add more. They always try to turn around and give you another goal. It's not like a traditional console game or a computer game where there's a starting point and there's an ending point. Even if it's an open world game, there's still a point where the game will end. Now maybe you can say it's less so for some games that are coming out, like Fallout 4, to where there's so many levels that you can go for that you can almost say that there's no ending point. But for the most part, on a traditional PC game, there is an end point. And the closest thing that you can say that there's an end point to this is when you get to the max level. But even if you get to the max level, there's still constantly better gear out there. So I don't feel like there's as much of a need to try to package this into smaller bites, because this game has got nothing to do with small bites of anything. It's all about just the never-ending grind. That's the reason why the trade skills were such a pain in the ass. That's why people would spend so many hours. I mean, even before the bazaar, when I would keep a tune logged on just to keep somebody at the bazaar selling, even before that, I'm sure the hours I had on this game playing were insane. I can't even begin to remember. When you go ahead and hit slash play, they'll tell you when the character was born and how long you've played them. I'll give you an example. Here we go. Played. Which side is coming? Here we go. Birth date, January 31st, 2017. Total time playing, 14 hours, 34 minutes. 14 hours, 34 minutes. Already. Already. That's insane. And I'm only level 15. Now back in the day, it used, when their maximum level was level 60, it would take you about 6 months if you didn't power level or you didn't know people that would help you out. Of course, I also spent most of my time soloing. I would group with people when I found some good people, but otherwise I just didn't want to deal with the drama. So I would usually go it alone. Ooh. I just remembered another zone. I was thinking about some of the crazy stuff I used to do. There was a zone, what was it? Oasis of Marr? Was that it? And I'm thinking maybe we should go over there instead of Highhold. We may have to turn around, skip over, and skip up into the plane of knowledge, but it would be worth it. It'd be a fun zone. Let me find someplace safe, relatively safe, to go ahead and look at the map and figure this out. Wow, I'm actually surprised here. Northern Karana, we got a bunch of grays. And there is going to be a couple hill giants running around. Grimfeather, that was the name of that one. Gray wisp out here. That's actually kind of shocking. Hey, look, a silver mist wolf. We already know it's a different wolf, but hell, we don't care. Wait a minute. Nope, it's lioness. Oh, hell no, you don't. Good kill, puppy. What the hell was that? He resisted? Ouch. Somebody hit him hard, and it wasn't me. See, now I'm completely infatuated with the idea of that other location, and I forgot what I was talking about. Yes, it would take about 6 months to level to 50, and then it would take another 6 months to get to 60. So it would really take about a year worth of time invested. And that's my bridge already? Get out of here. Yeah, already. Huh. I know, it seems like a little bit odd. Northern Plains of Karana used to be the only place that would drop high quality lion pelt, and it had to be from the main lions. I'm not sure if they're called the Great Plains Lion or what they're called, but yeah, you couldn't just get it from any mob, and this was the only place. And it wasn't a common drop. If you got that thing, it was worth some money. Even when money was tight, it was still worth some money. Because it can be used to make a special quiver that rangers love. I'm not sure if it was a bonus to rangers or what it was, but let's see now. I want to take a look at this atlas. All right, we are over here. It wasn't, maybe it was in, I want to say it was south of the Freeports. Oasis of Marr. Damn, I got a good memory. The only thing that's stopping me from going there is I would hate to go there and find out that we're already too high of a level. Northern Row was newbie zone. Tamoris Deep, that was a dungeon. The Gux, Inethul, that's where the trolls are. That's Troll's home. Grob, that's Troll's home. Edar Forest, that's an addition of a later one. I'm tempted to go down here, go into the Oasis of Marr. Let's see. What the hell is this? Zone 9 disabled. Minimum level. Oh, hey, wait a minute now. Oasis of Marr. North Row, minimum level 1. Where the hell is Oasis of Marr? Is it under Marr? Oh, you have got to be kidding me. It's right there, and it's not in here. Norrath, Northern Karana, Ocean of Tears, Agok. Okay, that is just a little bit aggravating, peoples. The Void, the Ruins, man, the Oasis of Marr, maybe? The Over There. I remember the Over There. That was a good time, it was right there. The Guild Lobby. Highhold. It even says level 10 for Highhold minimum level. This is interesting. I cannot, I'm sure it existed, but I really can't remember it that well. So, what do you two think? Well, mercenary and pet. I'm feeling the urge to go there. This could be a massive mistake. It could be the same basic levels as Blackburrow, but I still want to go there. Farmer. There's the Druid Circle. We'll go to the Nexus Stone, take that up. And trying to remember where all the down points for the Nexuses are. The Nexus Stone will take us up to the moon. I don't want to say that there's a down point. In the rows, but there might be. I think I'm getting my wizards, my little wizard things, I can't remember what they're called, mixed up with. Where is the Nexus thing? I'm surprised I haven't seen that giant floating around, because there was two giants floating around here. Unless somebody killed the giants that was passing through, and no one came in here and started killing mobs again, and then they killed the placekeeper for the giant, causing more giants to appear. Because the giants are not a normal spawn here, the hill giants. They are uncommon. Oh, I spoke too soon. Hi, little giant. Or big damn giant. That's good money. How's the favorite thing to farm is hill giants. I bet you it's still a favorite thing to farm. I don't know. That might be stretching it. Journey to Lucilin, yes. Take this, just stay inside the circle of the spires and keep the shard on your person. If you need another, simply ask me. Portal will open soon. Man, we could have just went to use our origin spell, our gate. 2 minutes till teleportation. Yeah. So you see, it wasn't that bad before the books. I mean, even when they did this, this was the first thing that moved you to Uslan. This was the closest one on this side of the world. There was one in Fadeware, which Fadeware is. No, not that. Here we go. All right, let's back this thing up. No. Oh, that thing. All right. All right, there was one in Fadeware, one in Lucilin, the Nexus. And I'm wondering if there was one in Otis. There may have only been four. But I want to say there was one over here, too. I could be wrong about that. Where's Nexus? Velius. Alarius. That's new. That's new to me, and I'm sorry. Velius the Ice. You know, I never did. I went there plenty of times, but I never really got it. Fadeware, it's craziness. I loved it. Lucilin, the moon. There was so much lag, it was hard to. Uh-oh. Here we go. We are being teleported. Or about to become active. Come on now. We are within the circle of the spires. Yes, we are. Didn't they change it? I thought they changed it. There it goes. Boom. Yeah, baby. Yeah. See, it wasn't that bad, now was it? All right, let's take a look at our Nexus map. To Allaire, to the Fadeware, to Anatotion and Shadowhaven, to Knowledge Portal, Avelius and Otis. The Bazaar and Kunark. Neath being lair. Where in the hell am I at, anyways? Oh, that's pretty damn bad. I'm here. I don't know where here is. Maybe it's, I'm in the underground. Bazaar, Nethbian. Now I'm curious about Nethbian. Oh, great. I'm gonna have to download the maps because I'm not gonna play that. I'm sorry. I know that's pretty damn cocky. What about Nethbian? The Nexus. Nethbian Lair. That was some more fun. Don't tell me. Everything I want to look up. There it is. That's being minimum level 15. That is us. But yeah, that's more of a pain in the ass than it is fun. Alright, then the starting zone. Let's go see what happens. Ending zone. Why in the holy hell? Zone path generator. Set end. No. No, 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 no. End. Set end. Why in the holy hell? Of course, if I can't find the Oasis of Marr, I can't set it. Anyone ever tell you that your programming is a pain in the ass? Yes, it is a pain in the ass. So what in the holy hell? Northern Desert Road, Northern Desert Road. Did the Oasis of Marr get eliminated? Nah, I'm not buying that. They didn't eliminate. Let's go North Row. Hey, no. Common Land, South Row. Freeport Sewers, East Freeport. Wow. This is not looking good, yo. Another one without a map. What is strange is it says it's there, but I can't connect to it. Why does it get the feeling I'm wasting all of your time here doing this like this? Southwest Anastasia, Wrath Mountains. That's where there's a whole bunch of hill giants. Northeast Anastasia. Alright, let's try this. Luceland, Palodial Cavern. What's awkward about some of these is running to them in itself. Because you have to get through a higher level one to get to that one. Shadow Weaver's Thicket, Maiden's Eye. There's Nethbian. Oh, the hell with it. We're here. Listen underground. Right to Nexus. Let's just go north. I'm tired of wasting y'all's time, okay? This is a pain in the ass, but yeah, I think the experience is good. No one else is here. Dun, 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 dun. I know what I said about doing things old school and the grind, and I'm not talking about this right now. Remember people killing these guards just because. No, what I'm referring to is those damn maps. As one thing, I am not eager about Getting myself into a situation. Where I don't have the maps, I have no clue what the hell is going on. Now, the downside of this place is the massive amount of trains you can end up pulling. They're red. Maybe there are lower ones over deeper in. Maybe those were the higher ones, and the lower ones are down here. Not even finding anymore. I don't even know what level this zone is over here. Dawn Shroud Peaks. I think we are way too low of a level for this. Dawn Shroud. I think we are way, way, way too low of a level for this place. I remember. More reds. Remember pulling mobs into here. That way you were close to some place that you could run away, which was over here. Well, we got another achievement. Someplace else that we've been. You're getting the grand tour of all of Norrath. Well, now we're not even on Norrath anymore. Now we're in Lucillin. I want to say that those Nethbians were the higher level mob, and there was a lower level mob somewhere around here. Hey, there you are. But they're going to come out in trains. I'm wondering if the next zone over there, if it's something that I can handle better. Because I think this is a desert zone over here. And I want to believe that we used to go over here before we come into Nethbian. If this wasn't just we're going to wander around and try to bring back memories, I would have done some research and planned this out. I may not have planned it out too specifically, but I would have believed that I would have said that, well, we'll be at this zone for this level, and then we'll go on over to that zone for those levels. See, oh, hi there. Oh shit, he's red. Don't think the guards protect you from him either. Wait a minute, he's indifferent. Where in the hell am I at? Marisaru. Excuse me. Zone guard, we are in Marisaru. Minimum level 15, maximum level 45. Is that the mobs or All right, the gray hopper, he's not necessarily aggressive to me. So let's take a peek. Oh, I remember them. Those things are a pain in the ass. And more indifferent. Gray hopper. Oh, wait a minute. I'm wasting everyone's time. Origin. Hell with this. Was going to say, we haven't even killed anything that got us any experience, but that wouldn't be true. We actually have killed stuff that was blue and we got experience. See, this is part of the insanity of this game. When it was only the first expansion, or even the first three expansions, there was only so many places you could go, and you were also limited by the sheer time it took to travel. So you would never go too far, and when you did, it would usually be more for people that you trusted. Because if you did go, unless you were a wizard yourself or a druid, you would have to get somebody to move you to get you. What the hell? Did I just have a lag? You'd have to get somebody to move you. So you'd have to get a taxi. You'd have to pay that taxi. But as it became more and more and more zones, and people were spread over a larger and larger area, you ended up with situations. We got 13 people in here. Well, level 5s, huh? Wonder if it's somebody four boxing. You actually ended up with a situation where you would be going all over the damn place trying to hook up with groups and hook up with people, and by the time you actually made it someplace, the people already broke up and went their separate ways. You would use the looking for group finder, whatever they called the program that they built into the system to help people find groups. You would find your group. You would go all the way to the other end of the game through a number of ways, including teleport and this and that. Then by the time you got there, the people broke up. They went their separate ways. It's like, oh, I'm gonna go to bed. Yeah, I'm gonna call it a night too. Yeah, we're done. We're out of here. See ya. Hey, good group. And you're just like, wait, I just arrived. Oh, sorry, but hopefully you'll be able to find another group around here. So, anyways, what I'm gonna do now is the Oasis of Marr. Yes, I am going to do the Oasis of Marr after all of that, and I'll tell you why. As much as I like the idea of Highhold because that was old school, I remember being lost in that zone and going around in circles, and I just don't want to deal with it right now. Look at that. There's a corpse. That's a yellow. There's gotta be something in here hunting these guys. Holy smoke, there's 8 people out here. That's kind of impressive. It really is. That's kind of impressive. There's 8 people out here. I know I could do stuff up here in Crescent, and out here in Blightfire Moors, I think it's called. And they did create a lot of okay quests. I won't say that they're great quests because I just don't, not that entertained by them. But they do keep you moving. They keep you goal oriented. So, all right, where do I want? Oh, I hate this. Nexus portal, Tranquility portal, FV, the arena, Cabilis, the over there. Rivervale. Kempion, Caladam, Hallis, Eridan, Nexus, Great Divide, Cherval, Qeynos, Tranquility, Firiona Vie, Freeport. That's where we want to go. We want to go to the Freeport portal. And we're close. That's convenient. I think that's the Freeport one. If not, it's that one. No, it looks like this is it. Right, West Freeport. Where is it going to take me to? The other big city. In fact, this is probably the biggest city. Yeah, baby, we made it to Freeport. Another city you get lost in. Be curious just to see. Okay. Somebody has been here. Somebody has definitely been here. All right. I'll go through the tunnel down the north row. Anything's better than running through this various Freeport zones trying, well, we could use the finder. I'm sure it'll take us to the zone. But I just want to go by memory. I want to waste more of your time, people. This is the common lands. Not sure if it was here or Grimbadoo. I was telling you about how a giant used to pop up at the far end of the common lands. And I think they even merged the common lands. It used to be east and west, and I think they just merged into a single common lands. I could be wrong about that. Excuse me. There it is. That looks like the tunnel. There's also a dungeon down there. It was probably the first dungeon that you could go into. And I want to say that it was like best for like level 5 to 10, maybe 5 to 15. I can't remember which zone. I'm sorry, not zone, server. Which server would that I played on? I think it may have been Bristlebane. They always used the tunnel as the place to sell. And they would be like, oh, yeah, I got a bag of stuff to sell at the first torch in the tunnel. You would come down here. They'd let you look inside, look at their bag, and then they'd try to get you to buy stuff. Yeah, just a bunch of merchants in here. Eldon, what is that? Lost Dungeons of Norrath expansion. I think those guys are. One of those may have sold something, but I'm not going to go ahead and look at it. Maybe someone over there may have had some unique spells. I don't think that I have to worry about it too much as a mage, though. I may do a little bit of research. I might just go ahead and print out some of the spells just so that I can make sure that I don't miss any of my spells. Just like I'm also going to get my Wee! My maps. But that'll be a download. That way it'll be in the computer. In the game. Oh, I believe these were dervishes. Oh shit, look at that. The dervishes are blue. Look at this. They are blue, peoples. Let's go ahead and kill some dervishes while we're here. Let's break them. Are you ready? You think we can turn around and do this? I think we can. Oh yeah, single pull, baby. Just the way I like it. He rooted me. Did you see that? He rooted me. The bastard rooted me. Additional herbs? Raw rough hide. Am I still rooted? No. Alright, next pull. Hi. Boom, 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 boom. Boom. Uh-oh, an ad. We got an ad. Go kill him, puppy. Hey. Cutthroat golden teeth and crude combat shoulder pads. Another golden tooth. What's this? Glowing agate signal. Oh, they just changed the bum 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 bum. Alright, orc raiders are worth no experience. Not to me anyways. A drow snake. Oh, worth no experience. Now, wait, let's see. What if I do this? Will it tell me where the Oasis of Marr is? South row. Soul binder. Yeah, there's a soul binder out here. What's this? Freeport sewers. And four south rows. How about this? Let's look at this. One thing that. I know why. I remember. Go away. It's because they merged it. Yes, they merged Oasis of Marr and South Row into one zone when they changed it. That's why. Yes. I remember now. Well, let's do this. Oh, no. Let's. Oh, hi. Huh? A ghoul. Oh, boy, that's good, though. That's old times right there. The Dune Tarantula. All right, let's go ahead and nuke the ghoul. Huh? Go get him, puppy. Well, at least they're blue. This is my defense for being in this zone. Bronze. Yes, that's worth some money. Crypt mummy. Go kill, puppy. She got. She's got a ghoul root on her. Oh, that's my puppy's got ghoul root on him. What are we Defiant Plate and Spider Silk. Yay! Just what I always wanted. Gila monsters. Whole bunch of Gila monsters and Orc Raiders. Orc Raiders are like the I remember these guys. We used to turn around and set up along the tree line and just pull all these mobs. Pull them to the tree line and that group would be waiting. Good times. Yes, pure silliness with me out here. And this is even the new version. There was an older version of this zone. And that's the reason why I say I forgot that they merged Oasis of Marr in with South Row. Ah, gators. Gators. Crocodiles. Let's start killing crocs, baby. Boom. Oh, yeah, more good times. Remember this. You just turn around, go ahead, and if you were real good, there'd be people all up and down this damn beach killing crocodiles. And the real gulp people with a lot of balls would go swimming out into the water to make pulls because there's more crocs out in the water. Shimmering agate signal. Whatever. Deep water crocs. What is a deep water? Yeah, he wants to attack me. And you see, then we got orcs over there. Why don't you get there? Gotta watch out for the deep waters, because they're a hell of a lot harder. They really don't drop anything worth a damn, but they got good experience. And yes, I'm just still actually just trying. Trying to build up my skills. Defiant stone fragment. There's the deep water. Try to avoid him. And just pull this normal croc. Uh-oh. Okay, good. I thought we were gonna get ads. Wow, she turned around and stole my aggro. I'm impressed. Alright, let's go on up here and... Hey. Well, we were going to turn around. But we can handle one more. Ouch. There's a healing stone that I'm going to have to make. All right, where's that? Create item. Oh, it's a heat stone, not healing stone. Never mind. But let's do some bandages. Well, that turn gave us a quick amount of experience. It wasn't that bad. There we go. Made 7 at one pop. Thought it went up with the level. Do it 3 times. Then we'll switch back to Fang. I really don't like the sound of him growling behind me. We'll go through all of this stuff later. I'm wondering, with the way that drop was, and I haven't seen it before. All right, here, wait. A charm. That's good. I needed a charm. They give out charms in the tutorial. Actually, it's a pretty damn good charm. Waiting. Waiting for that deep water to go by. Let's go ahead. Wait. Come on now. There we go. Come on, baby. You have got to die. At level 20, I can start spells specialization, which there's six basic different kinds of spells. Like that spell I just nailed it with, an invocation spell, which are generally offensive spells. My spells, which rain of blades, and my summoning, those are conjuration spells. There's also divination, which almost no one will ever specialize in, because it's, I won't say it's crap, because it has its purpose, but as far as to specialize in it, it's stupid. Alteration, which is my gate spell. I'm not sure if it's alteration or abjuration, which is where most of the shaman and cleric spells come from. Maybe it's a little of both. Just depends on the spell. So yeah, you get less of a chance of fizzles. It costs less mana to use spells in that group, and I think they may even cause more damage. So I have to decide if I'm going to specialize in conjuration or evocation, because those are really my two best choices. I may not remember a lot, but I remember that. For a wizard, for example, they're basically their only choice was evocation. If you were not an evocation wizard, you were a fool, because there really wasn't much of an excuse. No, we're not gonna let you get away. Come here. I saw one success, but I fear that may have just been on, ouch. There we go, there's a one. Now, if you don't turn around, do something soon. That's it. Nuke And I get to work on my bind wound. And this is why we conjured the. There we go, bind wound up to 8. I wonder if I still have any of the originals. Yes, I do. Right there, I still have 8. I'll put them in front of them. Because I will tell you right off, as a mage, you want to conjure up as much crap as you can. You don't want to become reliant. You know, if it was something that I found, I would sell it. Those bandages. But because it came with the tune, I can't sell it. Oh, this is another signet. Okay. I'll give this to the warrior. No. Crude combatants. Shoulders. Yes, I can use that. So that one will go to the warrior, too. I think the warrior's already got one of those. But. Just to be safe. Bronze. I think he's got magical. But I'll still offer it to him. The juggling act. Look at that. See, decent experience. We're already almost 95%. See, the experience here is great. All right, now. Hi. I heard you. And now you die. I could just nuke the hell out of them all, but I've taken too many shortcuts, and that's why my offense sucks, and my defense sucks, and that's the reason why I'm over here getting hit. Oh, look at you. You so pretty. Oh, what the hell, a fizzle? This is gonna ding me. There's no way around it. This is dinging me, baby. We are hitting 16 with this little crocodile right here. Raymond, you're not going anywhere. Where do you think you're going? Told ya. Alright, let's go ahead and. Our spells, where are they at? Here we go. There we go, our next pet. And new shielding. That is totally sweet. Is there anything in, that we're hiding in here? No. Alright, so we get a new shield and a new pet. I think it was an air pet. Yes, 16. We won't turn around. Summon him. HP buffs. Shielding. We won't summon him. But if something happens, we will summon the new pet over the old one. There we go. Boom. Decent, decent. What were all these guys that walked by us? There we go. A caiman. Here come. Look at that. 16 one hand blunt. Do I really want to know how far in the hole I am? One. Oh, where do you think you're going? One good thing about the specialization, you can't get it just by casting. You actually have to put a point into it. So we have, it should be down here. Specialization. I guess it's not. And I can't remember what the magic number is. Anyways, let's see where our one-hand blunt is. One-hand blunt is 16 of 64. Whoa, that's bad. That is so bad. Our offense, 24 of 64. That's bad too. What's our defense? 31 of 74. Obviously, we've been getting hit more than we've been hitting. Laysai. All right, next mob. Hi, crocodile. You're gonna die. Oof, got him when he's almost out of range. I like that. Oh, defense went up. That's good. That's good. Keep on killing those crocodiles. I love this stuff. Yeah, South Row and Oasis of Marr used to be two separate zones. They merged it into one of the zones when they were remodeling the zones. They were going to remodel all of the zones. It didn't play out. Oh yeah, there's orcs up there. There's spiders. There's all kinds of crazy stuff if you keep on heading south into the desert. People used to come out of Freeport, they would go into the camps. Dervish camps, they do North Row, because there was two separate newbie zones in Freeport. I guess technically there's, no, there's not two separate newbie zones in for Qeynos. They may even, I want to say, I want to say that Freeport is three zones, but it may have been changed, and I don't want to say that. At one point in time when I played, it was three zones. I'll just say it like that. Now it may not be. Uh-oh, lag. Ooh. See, we already got 25%. We haven't even sat down yet. What's that? That is a desert madman. Oh, yes. I remember those sons of bitches. We used to kill them just for water. They're not exactly the easiest mob to kill either. They will nuke the hell out of you. Non-stop. Man, I guess they're a crazy druid. I guess that's the best way to describe them. The only thing they really have on them, well, at least he's only yellow, but I'm still injured right now, so I don't want to fight him. I bet you that he's white. So it goes Caimans to Crocs to deep water Caimans to deep water Crocs. And further down there are more deep water Crocs. We're just gonna heal up again. Try to get another level out of this. We're 90 minutes in. Hey, are you gonna attack? No. Good. Yeah, even though it says ready to attack, I'm not sure what the criteria was of making them attack. you will have all kinds of different people that have different schools of thought on the best way to level, to kill people, kill mobs. And I was always of the school that constant motion. You're better off to get smaller bites of experience, like dealing with these guys, but it's going to eat up, you're going to get hurt less, and it's going to eat up less mana, so you can kill a lot more mobs before you have to take a break. If I was to just kill yellows or whites or reds, it would take a lot more out of me, and I'd have to sit down a lot more often. And also, this makes for better video. You know, we got constant action going on. We are the gator. We are... What was the gator hunter? Alligator hunter? Was that the guy down in Australia? The one that got killed by a stingray. Oh, yeah, we're hurt. Oh, okay, we survived. That's okay. And now, we will just sit down. Sit down. And here. Work on that binding wounds again. It's almost mandatory for a mage to become an expert at binding wounds just because you can basically summon unlimited band-aids. On the downside, I'm not sure if it came with Plane of Knowledge or a later addition that just added the merchant to the Plane of Knowledge. There's actually someplace up by the bazaar that you can buy healing potions. Something to consider. See the raft coming in on its own right there. It's going to take, if we wanted to, we could take it out to Velius. That's the ice continent. I am honestly not sure if there are any low-level zones in Velius. And by low-level, I'll say anything below 30. I think the lowest level zone that they would have in Velius would be around 30-ish. But I could be wrong. It has been a decade. Oh, I forgot to keep up burn on my... No, he still got it. No, he doesn't. Very burned. Burnout. He's got his own. Yeah. How long is that good for? An hour and 5 minutes? That's impressive. That's a nice little length. That's a nice little length of time. We're almost 50% through. 47%. That's decent. Alright. Cayman, come here, puppy. You're gonna die. See, if I was... Boom. If I was pulling, that's about the way I'd do it. I'd get, once he started running, I'd go running off and look for another mob. Keep constant motion coming into the group. One group would hang out in one particular beach spot on the beach. And somebody else would actually pull for the group. Hell, some groups would even have two pullers. And when one mob was actually kind of hard, they'd shout at one of the pullers to not come back right away. And the guy would literally run around in circles with the mob chasing him. Be able to take that one because it's a lore item and I got one already. This one's being a little bit harder because I took some extra hits on that one. One thing that's aggravating about mine. I would set her to end auto assist to where she would actually wait for me to ask for her assistance. But let's go ahead and strike him too. Give it to me. Ow. Ow. Where to go, puppy? You took the aggro from me. To put on band-aids. I'm not sure, and it's kind of hard to tell at this low level of experience with the band-aids because we're only at 11 skill, but band-aids only take you to a certain level of health, and I cannot remember what that level was. And I think the level may even go up the more your experience goes up. And I know that the band-aids are basically free for me, but I don't want to be wasting time and effort. Alright. Crude, Defiant, Mana, and Endurance. Crude, Defiant. We got one in there. Crude Defiant, we got one in there. Oh, what about here? In the feet. No, we got something in the feet, too. Something in the wrist. Got something in the feet. Okay. What's this? Leather. Bah. There you go. That's the ultimate test right there. If he didn't come after me. Ah. When he walked right over me, nothing's going to make him attack me. Except for me attacking him first. 77%. And let's go ahead and get our groove on. Sure, there is a recipe for gator meat, and I'm sure after spending many levels here collecting gator meat. I used it. And we will just leave that comment at that. Spun me around. I'm left wondering if there's a bonus in this zone. This may be a hot zone. But it seems like the experience is relatively high. I'm not ready to deal with him. Oh, look, a kitty. Okay, don't have no experience. No, I don't want to deal with the deep water. Let's just keep killing the blues. If I was at full strength, I'd probably be willing to deal with a white. But since I'm not at full strength, let's just go ahead and keep on pulling blues. There's also an island out here. It was not, it used to not be an island. I think it has something to do with some class is epic, and there's four reapers on it. And once you piss off those reapers, or it may have been called something else, but whatever. Once you piss those sons of bitches off, I don't know if I can move them in underwater. Yes, I can. Good deal. Once you piss off those reapers, they wander around the zone. And they're specters. That's what they are. They look like grim reapers. And once you piss off these specs and you get them, they wander around the zone. And once they start wandering around the damn zone... Yep, that's a lore item I already have. And once they start wandering around the damn zone, they just start killing everything random that they run into. Well, attacking everything randomly that they run into. So, yeah, you would hear people shouting. Now, why in the world they always chose to do this? They would always run to that dock. These people that would try to pull the specs and kill the specs, and once they failed, they would always say, specs to the dock, and they would run to the dock. I never did figure out why they always ran to the dock. Because it wasn't someplace you could just zone to on your own. If the raft wasn't there, you couldn't take them there. So we always did wonder. And they would shout that, specs to the dock, and be like, no, take them someplace else, asshole. We don't want the specs. That was in the 40s. All right. Are you going to ding me? Are you going to ding me? Are you going to ding me? Come on, ding me, ding me, ding me. Uh-oh, what's that? That's a mummy. That's your ding me. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And see, they're still blue. They are still blue. It's a beautiful thing, this zone. What, we started off at 15 and now we're at 17? I bet you we could hit... Well, we won't be able to hit 18 in 15 minutes. Because, yeah, I still haven't taken a video over 2 hours. And I'm not sure how that will work out. I mean, technically, I guess you could say that all of that craziness of us running around, not doing a damn thing, could be cut out. But you know what? That craziness of running around, trying to figure out where you're going to go, what you're going to kill, what's a good place to get experience, that's part of the game. That's part of the grind. That's part of the charm of the game. That's why I thought it was very funny when Daybreak said that no matter what they did, they couldn't make EverQuest. See, green. This is the first green that we've seen. Daybreak said that no matter what they did, they couldn't make the game fun. They couldn't make EverQuest Next fun. And I was like, what the hell are you talking about, fun? This stuff was some of the most aggravating shit I've ever played in my life. And you're talking about fun? I don't know what you're talking about. Oh, shit. I mean, yeah, I got enough mana. I could always throw another nuke on him. Percent already. And I always record these in blocks or groups, whatever you prefer to call it. So I probably will log out and in a few minutes and then just continue on and start up another part just because it's easier to do that. It also gives me a chance to have a couple of days of material so that when an incident like over the weekend happened where I wasn't able to log in for days because of errors, the problems that Daybreak was having, that I can still upload every day because you have to keep that constant uploading going on to be friends with the YouTube algorithms. And I'm not really sure what my honest... here we go. You cannot bandage a target past 70%. So now we know. I knew there was a number. I just wasn't sure if there was a warning that came with it. Now we know there is. And knowing is half the battle. Boom. Crocodile. Time to die, homie. Wow, that's actually pretty sad. But we are at 17. One hand blunt. So yeah, we're going to keep this going, baby. As long as the experience is good here, we're going to keep on killing stuff. I may even go up to Northern Row. And... may even go up to Northern Row and bind myself to the soul bind. Oh, damn. Did you see that? He resisted. Did he resist? No, I fizzled. Oh, spell is interrupted. Spell's interrupted again. You're pissing me off. There we go. Uh-oh, he's running. He's running. Where do you think you're going? You're not going any place. You're gonna die. That's what you're going to do. Alright. Oh. I saw something up here. Hey. Did you see that? He climbed the trees. That's bullshit on a stick. Alligators don't climb trees. And just to be a smart ass, I'm hoping my mercenary can handle one. Oh shit. Alright, puppy, kill him. What I'm curious about is I'm noticing a lot different drops with the magic stuff that randomly drops for my level. I'm noticing a lot more different stuff here in this zone than I saw over on the other side of the world. And I'm wondering if those drops are random because of my level or because of my location. So, like, just something to wonder about, something to think about and wonder about. Where are we at? We're over 40. 42%. Damn shame we can't turn around and go ahead and get another quick level. But I don't think we can get 60% in 7 minutes. I do think I'm going to have to make some more band-aids. But that's okay. We're moving up in our bind wound skill. See, we're at 19. We're just steady climbing. There's a lot of mobs floating around here. He runs, I'm attacking that thing. Like I said. I know the game is only green, but the hell with it. Watch this. Boom. You're dead. Another green one? That sucks. What is it? Crude Defiant. Yes. And now I'm wondering if that is... Damn, another green. There we go, a blue. That's better. I'm not sure what the percentage was when we first started way back in Qeynos. And also, I'm not sure how in the hell I'm going to log this down. Jeez. Because I usually put down in the information where I've been, what I've done. This one, we've been all over. We went. Started off in Qeynos, went to the hills, went to Western Karana, Northern Karana. We never made it to Eastern Karana. Then we went up to the Nexus, went to Nethbian, Maris Saru. Said the hell with it. Oh, we also went to the other one. I can't even remember the name of that zone. I've hunted there though before too, and I can't remember the name of it. Dawn Shroud Peaks, that's what it is. Gone to Dawn Shroud Peaks. Did Origin back to Crescent. Went to Blightmoor. Went to POK. Went to Freeport. Down to Northern, into the Common Lands, through the tunnel, to Northern Row, and now to Southern Row and Oasis of Marr. Boom. That's where we've been today. That's a decent amount of traveling. Well, with that, I'm going to stop this video here. Leave a like button, if you would, please. Subscribe. Leave your commentary down below. And all of this helps. Try to get the algorithm up. Develop something. Grow something beautiful in YouTube. As I develop my personality and my cadence and exactly what I'm going to be doing and become on YouTube. And he just interrupted. Ah! Kill this son of a bitch for interrupting my speech before we go. Boom. I'm gonna nuke the hell out of him. I'm gonna give him another nuke just to make him a quick death so I don't run out of time. Boom. Like that. Don't interrupt. So we're gonna leave at 58%. Hey, we will turn around. See you next time. We'll keep this going. And we're going to turn around and see how far we can go on this zone before we go on to the next one. Much love. See you people next time. Bye-bye.